job of the National Football League. And the spotlight is on Nick Chubb. He really helped drive them a week ago with a 3-touchdown game. It's the Cardinals and the Raiders, and it's all up next on EA Sports.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Las Vegas, Nevada. Today we've got a Week 5 matchup in store here, as it'll be the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Las Vegas Raiders. Hi again, everyone. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at the Raiders here entering play. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories. Meanwhile, for the visiting Cardinals here, it's been all systems go in this first month. They're off to a 4-0 start.
And as Scout folks believe that this is a team that's built to go all the way. You can't win the Super Bowl in September, but they're telling everyone that they're going to be there in the end.
Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports.
This taking in at the goal line.
And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Escaping the pressure right. And his first pass is incomplete. You look at this Raiders defense. They enter play here, number 11, just outside the top 10 in the league and stopping the run.
I still cracked up a little bit after we left our meeting with the defensive coordinator. Because I said to you, stop me if you've heard this before. How about him saying, well, first order of business, we got to stop the run. Of course you do. He's got a good unit. But facing the number one rushing team, they have to stop that in order to have a good performance.
12 yards the pickup. Good enough for an Arizona first.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, this shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea. Slow him down.
And down he goes. Max Crosby in there to get him. And that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. And some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. That is going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders' 45-yard line. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So here's a 1st and 10 now in Raider territory at the 45-yard line. A play-action fake. They'll look to throw. And leading the pressure right. The defense loses and it's complete. And he's going to get this down inside the 5 before he's out of bounds. A huge play there for Arizona. 42 yards.
We expected this defense to be tested by this passing game coming into this one. And there's an example on this first possession of the game.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Cole Kmet, his 3rd touchdown now on the air. And the Cards are on the board first here in Vegas. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? Remember what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early.
On 4th down, A.J. Cole comes on to punt. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here is away. This is brought in at the 21. A pretty good punt, but a nice 13-yard return. And the Cards will take over 1st and 10. So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their 2nd drive of the game. They'll be looking to duplicate that 1st drive, the one that got them that
first quarter. This defense has zero answers for what they've seen so far with the ball in the air. I'm not sure how they're going to change things around, but offensively, I keep attacking. I keep throwing the football until they make me change.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. Pretty much unreal, not just in terms of yardage, Charles, but also throwing the three touchdowns as well.
When you put the whole package together, I can make you a pretty good guarantee right now. He's going to see a few more people in the box every time he lines up.
Yeah, I don't think that the defense has any choice. They've got to stop him. Can't let a repeat performance like that.
Agreed.
Second and one. Take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. A give running right is Chubb. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Yikes, a 40-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Second and 14. We'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. Three catches now this afternoon, the same number he had all of last week. Also, it's a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up the first down.
They'll run with Chubb. And he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 to the 6. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try to put it in that way.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. We'll see if they have something else in their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. They pass up the 30, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Raider D, they get the football back. Oftentimes with these gadget plays, these fakes... Here's A.J. Cole now, standing just outside his own goal line. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. Taken at the 37. It'll be a net of 40 yards, following it from the 44. And they will take over first and 10. The offense trots back out there. Let's turn our focus now to Nick Chubb. Whatever he was doing in September, they're hoping that that carries over now to October, because he was sensational last month.
He absolutely was, and we all know where it started. At the end of last season, right? All the offseason preparation, the weight workouts, the sprint, right? The vision that he had, what he was going to do this season. And, of course, it all came together with the rest of the team. Those big fellas up front, leverage, and boy, they get downfield, create extra blocks for them.
They really are. Everyone's been doing their job so far to create those holes. 10-0 to score after one on EA Sports. Cardinal football here to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a first and 10. Inside the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They go quickly here out to Moore. Great footwork, but still wrangled down before reaching the 20. The Cardinals hit a perfect 4-0 to start the campaign. And they've been playing their best football of the year, winners of 4 in a row.
And I thought they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
This is Cole. Touchdown, Cardinals. His first touchdown on the year. And his guy's now an extra point away from taking a three-score lead. A nice connection there, finding his target, and that'll put 6 up on the board.
Just like they drew it up in their playbook and reiterated it on the sideline.
So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now with this offense. They just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Just need a yard here. Second and one. And Chubb will trying to middle here. And he'll do a nice job here just to find his way back to the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard. So far.
And this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Now a give left side for Chubb. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 30-yard line. They run it again with Chubb. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Flush to his right. And he's just gonna get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's this one for the sideline, and this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds, and they'll see it sail out at the 10-yard line. The offense trots back out there. Let's turn our focus now to Nick Chubb. He's been good. His guys are winning so far. The recipe working here in the second quarter.
And he doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back, and that's what he's done throughout this game.
And that's the plan. We'll be hoping to continue that trend. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right of the yard. First half of action.
That's a big conversion there on 3rd down, because they did not want to give the ball up here late in the half. They'd love to take the clock all the way down and score. This will definitely help the cause.
They'll look to throw now on 1st down. He's going to rifle on deep left side. And it's knocked away.
Safety's creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They're trying to hit him over the top, unsuccessful.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield.
text each other for the post game. Safe to say one is not buying the other day.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. Just a gain of a couple there. And it'll be second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like bats, and they take a lot of time.
Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a gain of 11 and a Cardinal first down. He'll look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. That is incomplete.
Some coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obvious a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, it was not much of a window to get the ball in there. And it winds up incomplete.
On play action, they'll throw. That's to the sideline. Incomplete. Chains. Again, he'll drop the throw. And it tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Raiders will take it here as they get it up to the 43. Scoreboard as we get set for the fourth. Here's a 2nd and 7. Nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slows momentum so well and is taken down right after. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that'll leave him with a 3rd and just 1 yard. They'll try and run the option to pick it up. And decision to keep it turns out to be a good one. 11 yards in the first down.
All right, I don't want to get too poetic here where they talk about, you know, the eyes being the windows of the soul. You know what else the eyes do? They see the open spaces on a field, and those eyes carry your legs to those spots, and that's what happened on that play. He saw a spot, an opening, and went down.
Inside the 10. Touchdown. Nick Chubb, 52 yards. And the Cardinals add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too.
Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
There's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And now it's third and three. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. The play fake. He'll look to throw. And he'll find the open man. That's complete. And he'll go out of bounds. It looks like right at the 40. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection. Things you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
The Cardinals on third down. They've converted 6 times and could use a 7th here. This will be 3rd and 5. They set up the screen to Chubb. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. Call it a gain of 7 and it gets him a new set of downs.
As many sacks as this defense has, you can understand their willingness to try and get upfield and get another. So what a really smart play call here to use their aggression against them, go with the screen, and they're able to get the first down.
They go quickly here out to Moore. Nice little juke. They'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
Stiff-armed him. And he's brought down after a very nice game. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
It hasn't been the cleanest game for him, but there was a sign of improvement as he looks towards the next one. Nice bit of scrambling to move the sticks, and even more importantly, he didn't risk adding another interception to his ledger.
Chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Cardinals are well on their way to a 5-0 start as they extend their lead. I've heard you use the term put-away drive, and that right there seemed like the definition of a put-away drive.
Yeah, it certainly just pops right up out of the...
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Short throw, and that's hauled in by Mayer. And he's up in this at the 33, following a good pickup of eight.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. That is not complete over the middle. That's Myers. And they eventually get to him at the 17 after a pickup of 17 into the red zone, first down. Now here's a throw, it's complete. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll look to throw again. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. It's been all passing all the time on this drive, 5 for 5, and now first and goal.
Feels like a case of, until they stop us, we might as well keep running the offense that we like to run. Don't change up and do something different just because you think you need to.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. Jeremy Rucker, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Raiders are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. They'll look to throw. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So they couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Cardinals hands team able to secure the football. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Escaping the pressure right. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down.
It's been a fun game for him so far, but I think he tried to do just a little too much that time. Give the defense a rare win on that snap.
They'll try and wind down some clock with Chubb. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Now that's a nice play. You've got me fired up, partner. But can they do it back-to-back plays? All the training that you go through as a defense for these situations, when you have to get the ball back, everything you go through, holding up the runner, raking it in the football, getting to the passer, knocking it out of his hands, whatever way, they have to get the ball back.
Now can they stand tall again for a huge fourth quarter stop? And the Raiders call on a nickel set here for third down. Set up to throw. And it is caught. There he goes left side. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. That one looks like he'll throw here. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
They go left side on the ground, LeChubb. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Nick. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. They'll look to throw now on first down. And that's complete to Adams. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. Again, he'll drop the throw. Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down.
Guys with his talent in the pocket aren't supposed to be getting hit like this. And you know an intense conversation with the offensive line is going to occur after this one. Might not be from him, but the offensive line coach will have plenty to say about this game. And definitely not a lot of answers.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. This is taken at about the 14. It's a return of 5 following a punt of 42 yards. And control of the football switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. There's a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ballgame.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on one of those high-end sports cars, what's the top gear you can get into. This offense, they certainly were there in this one, huh? Everything clicking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
So for the Cardinals, their strong September has carried over to October as they move to 5-0.